Good morning, and welcome to Naturally Kim's Knitting. I'm Kim, and this is my podcast all about knitting, dyeing, spinning, anything crafty related, basically, that I happen to be doing that week. Today is March 22nd. It won't come out till the 23rd, but today's the 22nd, and this is episode 58. Woohoo! I'm so happy for every episode. You know, it doesn't matter. I was doing woohoos, I think, on the second or third podcast. So, hey, I have lots of goodies to show you today. A finished item, lots of things on my needles, as always. And I might as well just get started, huh? Oh, before I do, I want to welcome everybody who's viewing, whether you're a first-time viewer or you've been viewing this for quite a while. I welcome you. I love you, and you're the reason that I do this. I never meant to make that as my catchphrase, but because it's not something that I'm saying out of, I don't know, out of duty. I'm saying it because it's true. If it weren't for you guys, I would have no reason to do this, and I would just be sitting back knitting away and going stir crazy. So I just love that you allow me to come onto your screen to talk with you about this crazy stuff once a week. Okay, if you see me sipping tea, I seem to have a little frog in my throat, and I've got some vanilla caramel tea in here. It's from Republic of Tea, and it's called their Cup of Cake. It is delicious, and if you want something sweet without having to add sugar or honey to it, this is good. Okay. Let's see. Let's start with my milkweed sweater. It's right here on my lap. I am so thrilled. Get it the right way. So this is the right side. You may not be able to see it real well. This is the right side, and here's the armhole. And right here is the collar. I'm sorry, I have this all twisted up. This is the collar, and it's going to come around so that it will join with the other collar, which I did on the other side, of course. But, so, right now it's just seed stitch. And I'll be doing that till I finish, and I'll probably finish this. Depending how much knitting time I get, I might finish this today. You know, I love both sides of this, but I should show you the correct side. So there's all my cable work and my lace work, and this is out of Ella Ray Classic Heathers, and this is called the Milkweed Sweater. I don't have the picture up here with me today. I am sorry. But as much as I don't like doing sleeves, I think I'm going to love these sleeves. They have a cable on them, and I'm going to be that much closer to being able to wear my sweater. Yay! I cannot wait. Even if it's summertime. There's cool days in the summertime. I can wear my wool sweater. Sorry about that. Now, the next thing I've almost caught up on, you know, I had my missing yarn. I think I have all my yarn right now, at least for a while. This is my annual temperature afghan. You're going to see ends. I haven't wove all the ends in, but this is my annual temperature afghan. And each zigzag is one day's temperature. So if you had the key, you could tell what the weather's been like from now and from the first day of January until this is Wednesday, set through Monday, because I'm only a day behind. Isn't that beautiful? It's unique. That's what I love about it. I did it off my own little color code, but I got the weather, I got the temperatures from, WeatherGAN. You just put in your country, Celsius or Fahrenheit, and from what days you want it from, and they will send you a graph for that time period. So as I've told you before, since I'm doing one for myself, I went back and I got patterns or got graphs for my daughters and my sons and my grandchildren, their birth years. And this is my daughter's. I'm loving this. I asked my husband, I said, how wide do you think I should make it? He goes, why don't you do it 2 weeks? So this is from the beginning. It's a memory blanket pattern. You can find this on Ravelry for free. But this is the memory blanket pattern, and I love how there's all these honey-colored squares, or diamonds, right in a row. And this is one, the one I finished with yesterday, and so I'll be getting ready to add one here. And I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I counted last night, but I don't remember. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So I have 10 of these diamonds across, so I have 4 more to do. And then I'll be through with the first and second row. That's my daughter's annual temperature afghan from 1983, from the day she, well, okay, from the day she was born in 1983 through the day before that in 1984. Yay! I should tell you, the annual temperature afghan mine is Frankie Brown's 10-stitch zigzag, and the yarn I'm using, it seems dark today, I'm sorry about that. It's a beautiful sunny day. The yarn I'm using for my afghan is KnitPicks Wool of the Andes. For my daughter, I feel scattered, and I apologize. Mine is KnitPicks Wool of the Andes Sport Yarn. My daughter's is KnitPicks Swish DK, because I thought California, she might appreciate a lightweight afghan. She's always chilly. I don't know if you remember me talking before. She's always chilly. So hopefully she'll get some use out of that when she's having one of her cold days. So let's see. That's the temperature afghans. Now, I have the sock that I call the mystery yarn sock, because I love this. I told my husband, I said, I am so upset. He goes, why? I said, because I cannot order this yarn again, because I don't know where I got it or what its name is. But this is my mystery yarn sock. I love how these colors just kind of blend into each other. This is a sock for me. I do have 2 socks that I'm doing that are for the men's kitchen, so I don't feel so bad. Or the soup kitchen, sorry. So this one's for me, though. I absolutely love this. So that's my mystery yarn sock. So I don't know the name of it, don't know the colorway. If anybody recognizes it, please let me know. I would love to give credit where credit's due. And if you know the color, if you know the name of the kind of yarn it is, I mean, it's a sock yarn, fingering weight yarn, I could always go on there and find the color. I just have no idea. And I love it. I did these on size 1 needles. See, I've got the toe started on the second one. I haven't started any of the pattern yet. No. So there's the toe on the second one. It's just a simple, well, no, it's not. It's a pattern I made up. I don't even have a name for it. Maybe I'll just call it mystery sock. I don't know. So anyways, I love this sock. I love the way it feels. I love the way it looks. If I had one complaint, it does split or fuzz every once in a while. But, you know, I can handle that. That's not a big deal. So if anybody does recognize that, please let me know. Okay, so there's that one. Let's go on to my kindness shawl. I had to think. It is in my Me and Dammy and Cece Coffee Plus Knitting Plus Coffee Plus Knitting Equals Yummy bag. I bought this as part of their package deal with their book. It's a cute little bag. And it has my kindness shawl on it, which hopefully will look similar to that when I am done. Hopefully. Except it'll be in purple. I wonder why purple. It's not like it's my favorite color or anything. You can't really get a good view of it because it's on these needles. But you see the lace work there. This part was just stockinette stitch with increases once in a while. But then we got 2 different lace patterns here. It is beautiful. This one is for me. The last time I was making a shawl and it was supposed to be for me, I gave it to my daughter, my future daughter. Maybe I shouldn't say that. They're not officially engaged. To my son's girlfriend, dear Rachel. So, and I didn't mind because, and she loved it. She actually, well, she wore it in front of me one time. So that made me very, very happy. Now I've got another plain sock. I call it a plain sock because the yarn has a pattern in it. Oh, I didn't. I have to look up what that kind of shawl. Oh, I know what it's made out of, but I don't have the label right here. There it is. Sorry about that. From the Natural Dye Studio. This is, oh my, Blackmore Gate. That's what the purple yarn is. I kept this back here just in case. This is some of the yarn, the Godiva silk, that was given to me by Fizona. And the other skein was part of her prize package. So this one she told me to keep because it's purple. So I will put this in the bag so I remember. Godiva silk. It is wonderful. It is 75% single spun merino and 30% silk. It's going to be like heaven to wear because it's like heaven to work with. Anyway, back to this plain sock. The sock has a pattern to it. So even though I call it a plain sock, the plain sock is what I call the sock. I got through the heel last night, so I'm just knitting around to the cuff right now. But isn't that pretty? I just wanted to do something a little different. So I got this from Schachenmayr Regia. And of course, they don't have a color name on it. It's a number 03763. But I thought, oh, let's try this. I just want something fun. And I'm doing it for I'm doing this one for the soup kitchen because I'm way behind on my socks for the soup kitchen. I've got to get started making some hats before long for the kids going through chemo. I haven't done that yet. It's not like they take that long to work up. I was always working on them when I was balancing on my Pilates ball, and now I've got two Afghans that are taking up that time. So I may have to work. My daughter's doesn't have a time limit, and neither does mine really, so I really need to work on that once in a while. So if I don't have a hat to show you, or at least that I'm working on one next week, remind me. I want to make those chemo caps, okay? Oh, sorry about that. I've told you I'm having neck issues, and I go to see the orthopedic surgeon in 2 weeks, 2 weeks from yesterday. And I said, it can't come fast enough, but every time I turn my head a certain way, it sends a sharp pain. So, okay, it's neither here nor there. It's just that if you see me go, ouch, that's what it is. I just moved my head the wrong way. Anyways, then I have another pair of plain socks. Whenever I have socks that have a stripey pattern or like that Schachenmayr does, I'm never quite sure how the stripes are going to be unless it's my own pattern. So I like to do it plain. However, CC does have a pattern that's just specifically for striped socks. So if I do this one again sometime, I'll have to use her pattern. But this is Sirdar Heart and Sole, size 1 needles, plain sock. And I told you last week, I'm not fond of this yarn. It sticks to, the yarn sticks together and makes it difficult to work with. So I'm just not really crazy about this. Like this. Maybe that helps with the light. I don't know. I did used to turn my camera more. It just seems dark, which is so weird because it's not dark out. It's beautiful out. Okay, you know what? That's it for my knitting. Wow. Now. That was finished, by the way. Yay. I'm so happy. Try and get myself in the center of the camera now. I suppose I don't like to be in the center because even though I do a podcast, I don't like being in the center of attention. And boy, my hair needs cut. I keep wandering. I'm sorry. Okay, things that have been making me happy this week. Well, this is right on top. So I'm going to talk about this first. You know me and Roving and eBay. I get it on Etsy too. But I saw somebody selling these three Rovings. And of course, I saw this one first. And I just had to have that because it was called Spooky Purple. And oh, it's 1.9 ounces, but that's okay. It was up for bid. And I thought, well, I like her. I like the way that looks. So I got two other ones from the same place. And this one is called Cocoa Blues. I kind of like the way that works along. I'm thinking either I'm going to put this with the alpaca when I spin it, or some of my woolbothy. I might do that. And then this is called Blondes Have More Fun. And since I used to be more blonde, I thought, why not? So these are all 100% wool. And the purple one is 1.9 ounces. But I think the other two, yeah, are 2 ounces. So those will be fun to work out. And then from Etsy, from somebody who actually lives here in Ohio. I don't know if I mentioned that at the top. I'm in Lima, Ohio. So when I find something that works and creates things in my own state, I do like to look at their products and see if I can find a use for it. It's kind of like supporting local. But then again, if anybody sells things from the UK, I like to grab it too because I love the UK. I've been there twice, planning a third trip. Let you know when that comes closer. Anyway, so this is from Phoenix Fire Creations, Dyeing the World a Brighter Place. And their Etsy shop is Phoenix Fire Fiber. That's their card. And this is a fine merino, and it's called Forbidden Forest. And I don't know, I have been in a greenish mood as of late, because from the same lady, I got this merino, I don't know what that says. And this is called Enchantress. I just think it's funny, I'm in a green mood here. So I'm looking forward to spinning with those. And then, I don't know why, well, I suppose I was in a green mood because of St. Patrick's Day. And KnitPicks was having a yarn on their, or sale on their green yarn. In fact, I think it, oh, I won't mention it because I think it ends the day I'm filming this. I'm going to start keeping you informed of what they have on sale. And if you're purchasing it, maybe you can do it through my link and I get some credit. Anyways, I wanted a tonal. And they have this beautiful Preciosa fingering tonal. And it's called Tadpole. And I can't decide what I'm going to do with that. Probably a shawl. It's 100% merino wool. Around the throat. Shawl. Because I know that I had surgery a couple years ago, and I always like to keep my neck wrapped. And if I end up having more surgery, I'm going to want to do that again. So it's so pretty and so pretty and so soft. So that's the Roving. Well, I've also got Roving from Woolbothy this week. I didn't bring it over. I'm sorry, Woolbothy. And I put it with my other Woolbothy. I can't remember which ones it was. I love all their stuff, though. Oh, so beautiful. And I got my hand carders, which are hard on my arthritis, but these, I've been using pet brushes to card my yarn, my fleece. No fun. However, I got these, and I started carding my alpaca, and oh my goodness, it is great. I love it. So I've got hand carders now that are meant to be hand carders. So from them, and I got some yarn with them too. Oh, sorry, not yarn. That's coming the next time. Roving. The word just went out of my mind. Then I got one more thing that's making me happy. I'm yarn ball winder. No, I have never had one. Yes, I have always wanted one. So now I've got something to wind my yarn into balls, and I can actually make ball cakes, because I want to try something with dyeing, with yarn that's wrapped into a cake. So I'm looking forward to seeing that. I go onto YouTube and I find different ways of dyeing yarn, and I think, ooh, I'm going to try that. I did one the other day. Never going to do it again. Not even going to tell you what it is. No sense wasting your time, but that's okay. I'll find some use for it. So my goodness. I have been happy this week. Okay, so let's see. Well, you know, of course, I've been watching Geek and Sundry, Critical Role, basically, but other things too. Then my daughter, she talked about Pi Day, P-I Day, with her daughter. And so they did some math related books. And then they also talked about St. Patrick's Day. So they made some different shamrock things. So if you want to see some books that are good to read for those things and some activities to do, she had so many activities on there. Just go ahead and click on my link, and that will take you right to Beyond the Schoolyard. Fun things to do with little ones. And even her one-year-old loves getting into these too. So check that out. And I've not done a lot of book reviews this week, which means I'm going to be finishing a lot of books at the same time real soon. But I did do one children's book, basically, I would say third through fifth or sixth grade reading. And it was based off of a Dutch folktale, The Cat Who Came In Off the Roof. And it is so cute. It was a book review book, so I have it on my Kindle. But anybody who's interested in that, look at my book review. And if you're interested in buying it, after you read the book review, just go ahead and go through my link, and it will take you to the Amazon site, and you can get a good deal on it. It's a cute book, and I believe most third through sixth graders would like it because it's written in a fun way. It's all about a woman who used to be a cat and a man who's a journalist, but he only likes to write about cats. And it's how one helps the other, and it is just so cute. Okay, now let's talk about our craft alongs, because we are in the last week and a couple days before finishing our crafting for charity, which brings me back to my knitting my chemo caps. But my socks, if I were entering this, I would enter those socks that I've made for the soup kitchen. And if I get the other pair done, I would have put those in. I keep saying every week I'm going to put my temperature, update my temperature afghan in there. So I need to do that. Put it in my head. Get it in there. So I've got two craft alongs going on right now. One is crafting for charity. It could be anything as long as you're making it for charity. I've seen hats, socks, mittens, lots of wonderful things. The other craft along I have is the annual temperature craft along. And that can be anything that you do as long as it reflects daily temperatures for a year. So it's not going to be done until next January. But, you know, in order not to get behind like I have a couple times, it's helpful if you start them early. So the annual temperature one, like I said, it ends January 5th. And I'm going to have drawings throughout the year. However, nobody entered for March. So that drawing is passed. But if you put where you are now in there by June, I'm going to have another drawing in June, probably about the middle of the month of June. The crafting for charity, you only have till the 31st of this month. When I wake up on the 31st, I'm going to lock the thread, and I'm going to... And I'll do my random number generator, and we'll see who gets it. Now, I did have somebody ask me, because she had already taken a picture of five of her hats and several pairs of her mittens. And she asked me if she could turn it in like that. Yes. And each one of those will count as a separate entry. So, yay. And you never know. I had a first-time member who had just joined last week and entered the drawing for the CC book, and she won. So you never know, you could be the lucky one. Of course, both of them have the basic same rules. You can poly dip either of those in other craft alongs as long as it follows everybody's rules, okay? The prizes, I always give one of my skeins of yarn, and then it's other things as either people send them to me, or I see them at Etsy or something and I purchase them, or if I go to a craft show and I see something that would be perfect. So I've shown you the prizes Fizona has sent me to give away, and if anybody's interested in sending me a prizes for a craft along, just PM me on Ravelry and I'll get right back to you. More knife is Ona. Anyways, and I always use random number generator to find the winner because my it just seems like the fairest way because I don't want anybody to say, oh, she always picks that number or whatever, so I'm not going to choose it. Random number generator will. Anyways, for the craft along, anytime that you finish an item, for the crafting for charity, anytime you finish an item, put it in the post on Ravelry with your photo. If there's a pattern name, go ahead and put that in there because other people are like me and I might see something cute and think, oh, I'd like to make that. But if I don't have a pattern name, it's hard to find them sometimes. If you're doing it off your head, like I sometimes do, and you don't have a pattern name, that's okay. You must, for both of these, you must be a member of Naturally Kim's Knitting Ravelry group in order to participate. I've told you when I wake up on the 31st, I'll lock the thread. Well, actually, in my rules, I say April 1st. So when I wake up April 1st, I'll lock the thread. And the winner will be drawn on that day's podcast. Because I think that day is a Wednesday. If not, I'll be drawing it for the following week's podcast, whenever that is. And for any, for any craft alongs I do, the winners have 2 weeks from the time I draw their names to claim their prize. Now, let's see, anything different on my annual temperature craft? On the annual temperature craft along, if you're doing a project, post a picture in there and then keep me updated. Okay? I just want to see how you're going. I'll try to get my update in there today or tomorrow. I'm not going to promise today because with the podcast, sometimes it takes me all day to get going. So, maybe tomorrow. Anyways, other things that are possible prizes from me would be, I do have some yarn that I might put in. Some of my own yarn that I dye, and sometimes a pattern on Ravelry up to a certain price level. So anyways, I think that's it for my rules. If you want to know what the rules are, they're on my WordPress and my Blogger blogs. And I will also try to put them right underneath the YouTube video as you're watching. So if you're interested in the rules and you want to see, oh, I don't want to do this because it might be wrong, you can either send me a PM on Ravelry or you can just look at the rules. And that should help you. Okay. I think that's it. My goodness. I had a lot to show and everything today and a lot to talk about. So anyways, I think that's it. I hope, where can you find me? I can't leave before I tell you that. Where can you find me online? Well, you can find me, get all my things up here, because I don't want to forget anything. On Ravelry, I have my own page, which is Napier's Knits. Then I have Naturally Kim's Knitting. My Etsy store is Napier's Knits. Instagram, I'm knitting_Kim. And on YouTube, Blogger, Facebook, and WordPress, you can find me as Naturally Kim's Knitting. Okay, I think that's it this time. I hope everybody has a great week knitting, few, if any, mistakes. And I hope you have a great and wonderful week. It feels like spring is here. I hope it feels that way at your place. I love you. Big hugs. And have a super, super week. Bye-bye.